is debilitated in the ascendant and exalted in the seventh house. The native will be scholarly inclined. So you'll want to read, study, contemplate on multiple things, Cancer ascendant person. Right? And the person will be famous. The Cancer ascendant person will be a poet. Like, so he will love shairies or poems. In his young age, he will be troubled from many diseases. But at the later part of life, specifically after crossing 30, 32 years of life, he will be happy. And day by day, as the age of a Cancer person will progress, his money will also progress. His income quotient will also increase. 10th Lord being exalted in the 7th house indicates that the person will get happiness through wife. Despite the fact that his wife is not listening to him, still he will get happiness through his wife. The person, Cancer ascendant person, is generally intelligent, is virtuous, is eloquent, is religious. Right, but
Cancer's 10th lord in 7th house exalted. So he can do business of export import trading.
Yeah, export import trading he can do.
Okay.
Even 10th house indicating the sky. So, you know, things related to flight, you know, these courier companies, and things related to aeroplanes, flights, etc. is also very good.
Sir, ye jo principle hai, the same principle get even in a normal case. Matlab kisi ka actual mein 10th lord agar 7th house mein baitha hai, actual mein, wo same principle laga sakte
hai. Aata apply karna hi hai. Bilkul nahi. बहुत सही पकड़ा
मतलब उसको और लिख के रख लेते हैं मतलब जो आप
यस मेक अ नोट नोट इट डाउन एंड अप्लाई दैट यस
क्योंकि अच्छा सर एक बात और है कि अगर एक्चुअल के केस के अंदर जितना अप्लाई होगा वो ज्यादा होगा ना ये वाले हमारे वाले केस
से बिल्कुल बिल्कुल ये क्या है ना दिस इज अ फ्रेमवर्क इनके मोटा-मोटा फ्रेमवर्क है देखो एक ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड समथिंग दिस इज you make a framework, you are making a rough outline of the person. Rough outline of the person. Just one factor. Remember. So it is driving a car in a speed limitation area.
Sir, wo kya bolte hai? FLA, first level analysis.
First level analysis. Because you had planets and more input, so more and more precise. Ye jo result I am just telling you, no? The seventh lord exalted in this house, debilitated in that house. If that is actually happening in the chart, then it will match to the great extent. Right now, it is 60% match, 40% mismatch. Because the 20% you have to give to planet. Because here Rashi and house is there, but planet is where. So 40% importance you have to give to planet. Right. So it is the basic analysis, basic framework of the chart. And this frame, to understand this framework is very important. To understand the framework is very important. Because first of all, you should understand, you know, whether the person is wanting to get married or not. Timing marriage is another area. Marriage happy, marriage sad is a different area. Children from marriage or no children from marriage is a different area. First thing is there is marriage or no marriage time. So for that particular reason, the basic analysis, first level analysis is important.
Agar maan lo, agar we get the see the chart and if we see ki bhai 10th lord is in a 4th house, hai na? But if this with cancer thing, we are getting some different results. So don't you think there will be a conflict little where?
नहीं बोलो बोलो कैसे बोलो
मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि अगर मानो 10th house का lord actual के अंदर 4th house में बैठा है और यहाँ पे हमको ये पता चल रहा है कि 10th house का lord जो है exalt हो रहा है 7th house में तो ये actual में और जो हम मान रहे हैं virtually में इसमें थोड़ा सा result conflict नहीं हो सकता ऐसा नहीं हो सकता
नहीं
नहीं
होगा देखो मैं approach बताता हूँ right the result that we are telling right now the result we are analyzing is the result that the person will get in the bad result in the worst dasha, good result in the best dasha. The 10th lord in 4th house, what the person is doing, he will do every time. But when he becomes fortunate, he will follow the result of 10th lord exalted in the 7th house. When the time is bad, he will follow the result of 10th lord debilitated in the ascendant. So it depends on the time. Samay pe nirbhar karegi baat. Ye basic framework hai, that will always be there. So, इसमें देखो when we are saying na, that the fortune of this person will improve after marriage, now we are not clarifying he will become rich after marriage, he will become inheritance after marriage, or what he will become, we are not clarifying, but we are saying just he will become fortunate. So now the position of the seventh lord can only decide what type of fortune. But fortune will be there, that is guaranteed and for sure. Right? So that is the importance of the basic framework. Basic framework we only say because the analysis will never go out of this particular area. Achha, when you will listen to the whole class, Ankit, उस टाइम यू विल नो कि द प्राइम रीजन दैट वी वर डिस्कसिंग इज कि इफ द सेवंथ लॉर्ड इज इन कैंसर देन हाउ वी कैन प्रेडिक्ट यू नो इफ द सेवंथ लॉर्ड इज इन कैंसर टू प्रेडिक्ट द प्लेसमेंट ऑफ सेवंथ लॉर्ड इन कैंसर इज द प्रॉब्लम व्हेन आई से जुपिटर इन कैंसर यू लाइक एक्साल्टेड यू विल टेल द रिजल्ट व्हेन आई से मार्स इन कैंसर यू विल से डिलिटेटेड टेल द रिजल्ट व्हेन आई से यू मर्करी इन कैंसर यू विल से ओके मर्करी इज इन द साइन ऑफ अ एनिमी you will tell the result. But what about 7th lord in cancer? So if you have 7th lord in cancer, then the result of marriage told for cancer will be applicable for this person who is having 7th lord in cancer. So at that place, this basic framework of analysis becomes advanced framework of analysis. So, getting my point? Samajh gaya to? Abhi to basic hai. Abhi hum keh rahe hain isko ki cancer lagan ke liye basic fundamental hai. Theek hai? लेकिन सबका तो कैंसर लग्न होगा नहीं. नॉट एवरीवन विल बी बोर्न इन द कैंसर एसेंट. सो इफ यू आर हैविंग योर सेवंथ लॉर्ड इन कैंसर, देन टू जज हाउ द सेवंथ लॉर्ड विल वर्क, यू चेक द रिजल्ट ऑफ मैरिज फॉर कैंसर एंड यू टेल दैट रिजल्ट. नाउ इट विल बिकम एडवांस रिजल्ट, राइट? कैंसर एसेंडेंट पर्सन, सपोज ही इज हैविंग हिज सेवंथ लॉर्ड इन सजिटेरियस, then you check the Sagittarius class and see what I told for the marriage of Sagittarius. That will be applicable to this person despite the fact that he is born in Cancer ascendant, because he is having 7th lord in Sagittarius, the result of Sagittarius in marriage is going to come. Right? So using this way, this basic framework will become the advanced predictive formula.
Actual case. Achhi baat
hai. The 11th lord is debilitated in the third house, which means that the person will not be skillful in many things, right? He will be skillful in a few things that he know he will be highly skillful, but he will not be someone who knows everything. He will only have a few virtues, few skills only, right? The person will have all kind of wealth, be it vehicle, be it, fixed asset, bank balance, daily income, he will have all kind of wealth, but that comes after a whole lot of hard work and after crossing the 30-35 years of life. The person will also get many accomplishments, many awards, many honors, good recognition after the middle portion of life. And sometimes he have pain in gout, right? You know, sometimes you feel like something is piercing you from inside. चुभने के जैसा लगता है ना, ऐसा you sometimes feel it in chest, sometimes in other body parts you will feel like, you know, something is being pricked into your body from inside area. So that type of pain is indicated by the 11th lord being debilitated in the third house. शरीर के अंदर से शून्य चुभना, this is the result of the third house. कभी कभी लगता है ना, like gas, if you have gastric trouble, right? You know, if you burp, डगार लेते हैं ना, कैसा लगता है ऐसा throat में पूरा. You think that your throat is burning. So that is what is indicated by third house in disease. Internal burning. Okay. Now the 11th lord is exalted in the 9th house. Right? And because of that reason, the person will be fortunate, the person will be skillful, the person will be honored by the king, honored by the public, respected by the public, followed by the public, the person will be affluent. And the person will try to uphold what he said, right? See, there are two words. Truthful, in astrology, there you will see two words. Truthful, truth-speaking. Truth-speaking is indicated by the second house, okay? That if there is a good sign in the second house, person speaks truth. If good planets are in the second house, person speaks truth. In astrology, whether one speaks truth or not is not right. You will see truthful, satyavadi. Truthful means you made a statement and you stick to that. Getting my point? Satyavadi means I told you that if you have any question, ask me. And when you ask, I actually answer. That is satyavadi. I told you something and I prove it to be true. Getting my point? This is what is written. It is not written that the person will always tell truth. Nowhere in astrology you will find that the person will tell truth. No. It is satyavadi. That whatever the person promises, he will uphold it. Getting my point? So this is written in astrology. Whether the person speaks truth or not, that depends on the second house and the planet in the second house. Benefits, speaks truth. Malefics, doesn't speak truth. Specifically, it is dependent on the fourth house. Fourth house malefic, there is a malice in heart. Fourth house benefic, no malice in heart. So whether the person is truth speaking or not is the matter of both the houses. Right? And in other places in astrology, whenever truthful is written, it is whether the person is upholding his promises or not. If your husband says you get a meto, jo hai ki daru nahi pita, to sach mein nahi pita? Ya ki jab tak ladai nahi hoti, tab tak nahi pita. Ladai hogi uske baad to dekh lenge. That means he will uphold even if he speak lie. Yes, yes. If the satyavadi yoga is there, then suppose someone is a heavy drinker and he tells you that I don't drink. Satyavadi is the person that after telling you that I don't drink alcohol, leaves alcohol from that day onwards itself. Because he told you now, aage se usne nahi kiya. That is satyavadi. He told the truth. Ki subah se pee ke aaya nahi. Aur ab bol diya ki nahi peeta, ab se nahi piya. That is satyavadi as well. Okay. Yes, that is very good point, Dilumji. The 12th Lord is exalted in the third house and the 12th Lord is debilitated in the 9th house. The 12th Lord being exalted in the third house, the native will be devoid of parent fraternal bliss. His siblings will be of no use. Cancer ascendant's sibling. You know, are like he don't get any happiness from his siblings, be it emotional, mental, physical, spiritual. No kind of happiness from sibling is there. Point one. Cancer ascendant person will hate others and he will promote himself over everyone else. And given a chance for betterment, given a chance for nourishment, he will always keep himself first and will always try to push others out of it. Even if the person is deserving, the cancer person will be the one to promote himself, even by telling lies, and will make sure that the other person only gets his due, only gets his reward after this cancer person's wishes and desires are fulfilled. And this trait is with every ascendant that is having a malefic sign in the 10th house. Right? So cancer, 10th house sign, Aries. Aries is lorded by Mars, malefic. So every ascendant or every person having a malefic influence on the 10th house is a person who will first keep himself, right? That okay. Once I get this, after that you may distribute it to anyone. But I should get it first. This is what malefic 10th house, no? Bad karma implies. Got my point? More the malefic influence on the 10th house, more mean the person is. And more he's, you know, self-propagating. He wants things to come to him first. Come to him first. Getting my mind? That thing. And the 12th Lord is debilitated in the 9th house. So the person will dishonor his elders. Right? Badon ki izzat kharab karega. Specifically his gurus. I told you, the cancer person is not very good for Guru Bhakti. At one point or the other point of time, he starts thinking that Guru is a useless guy. I know better. Guru knows nothing. Straight with the answer. Just straight with the answer. But more applicable when the 9th Lord is in Cancer.
Shubham ji, you take Guru for 9th house or 12th house?